Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Sonia Gonzalez if you are new, and in today's video I'm going to be talking about my 2021 resolutions and what I learned in 2020. What I've learned in 2020: nothing is permanent. Isolation makes my mental health worse, as I'm sure this year has been a challenge to everybody. This has just been a really hard year. Seeking therapy and prioritizing mental health is one of the best forms of self-care, and I truly believe this. I know if I hadn't decided to start using telehealth and going to counseling and getting put on medication, I know that this year would have been a lot worse for me. So I highly recommend doing that. I use this app called Cerebral, and their website is called getcerebral.com. But it's literally $100 a month, and with that you get a counseling session every month, and you also get medication for if you're suffering with anxiety, depression, whatever. They will help you with that, and it is one of the most affordable things that you can do. I highly recommend that, and if I wouldn't have done that this year, I would be in a lot worse shape. Also, with that, dogs bring me pure joy and happiness. So I got a dog this year, if you don't know. His name is Milo. We adopted him from the shelter. He's a Aussie and mixed with something else. We're not sure what. But literally, he has made this year. Had him for 4 months. And these last 4 months have gone by so fast. And without him, I honestly think that I would be a lot more depressed. Animals are just so loving, and they have so much love to give. And I just think they're just so pure for this world. And so I'm really thankful for him. He made this year better. Also, obviously my fiance did, but get a dog if you are anxious, or you're depressed, or you're both, or this year has just been hard, or you're lonely. Get a dog. California is a good vacation spot, but I truly don't think I could ever live there ever again. This year was hard enough for everybody, but I think moving personally, like for me and Dakota, moving across the country to a place where we knew two people from our college that were living in LA, but other than them, we knew nobody going there. And so we went over there alone, and no family over there, and it was really depressing, and it just made this year even harder on us. I also learned this year, as many of us have, to fight for what you believe in, and to stand up for what's right, and to care about other people and support things even if it doesn't affect you. Support causes like Black Lives Matter, stuff that's important to you because you care about other people, and be empathetic. I've learned this year to trust God. I had gotten away from Christianity and my relationship with God, and this year has been trying, like I said, for us all. And I had to find God again. I had to seek God again. I also learned that there is beauty in simplicity and wanting to live a quote unquote simple life, and just not want anything extraordinary out of life isn't a bad thing. You know, I don't think that you shouldn't have goals and you shouldn't want to reach those goals, but I also think having a simple life and settling down and, you know, starting a family, not right now, like we're gonna get married, but we're not having kids just yet. But I think that there is just such pure joy that can come from simplicity. And I think before this year and everything that's happening, I didn't realize how important friends and family are. Not that I would need to be like right near family, but driving distance, you know, a couple hours away, not 20 hours away, it makes so much of a difference. Family's important. Friends are important. Having good, solid friends who, you know, have your back and support you and want, you know, you to be happy. I think that's really important to have people like that in your circle. Now, after that really long intro, here are my 2021 goals, if you care at all. So I want to get out of debt because I have acquired some debt this year. Me and Dakota both as a couple have acquired some debt from California. I'm excluding my student loans because I'm not going to pay them off in a year. That's not realistic. I want to start uploading 2 videos a week to YouTube and just grow my channel. I am really looking forward to just putting stuff out that I believe is important and stuff that I've wanted to talk about, but I've been too afraid to share. I'm just gonna be honest this year and let people know how it is. Another one of my goals is to apply to grad school. and start in the summer, and I have just been debating this. Also, my bangs are kind of crazy right now. I need to get them cut, but I've been debating this like off and on for a couple months. But I really do think I want to go back to school. I'm not going back to school for theater because I got my bachelor's degree in theater, if you don't know that. I have decided, I've always been interested in like mental health and the way people think. And so I think I'm gonna go get my master's degree in counseling. And I'm not gonna, you know, say like for sure, like that's exactly what I wanna do. But I'm gonna apply for grad school and start taking some classes this summer. And if I really think, you know, after taking a couple classes, I can see myself doing this and this is what I wanna pursue, then I'll do it. And if not, then I'll stop grad school and I'll figure out what's next, you know? It's just, life is just figuring out what you wanna do. I want to start eating healthier and working out consistently, focusing more on my mental health, which I feel like I already have been this in 2020. But even more so, I want to start journaling. I need to meditate. I know I get so stressed out and I have so much tension in my body. Literally right now I have tension in my throat talking because I'm not breathing enough. I just want to focus on being the best version of myself this year and being healthy. I would like to get back into acting if things start safely opening back up in Texas. In LA, things were starting to open up and you could audition for stuff, and if you ever did get cast in anything, you know, they would COVID test you, all that kind of stuff. Whereas here, things have been open this whole time, so I only want to start pursuing acting if things are safe, and hopefully with the vaccine, things will start being safer. So another one of my goals is, if you didn't know this, we're gonna move to Austin. So I just put that on here because that's a super achievable goal. And once I do that, I'm gonna feel really accomplished to mark it off. I want to read at least one book a month. I was trying really hard to read more this past year, and you know how it is, guys. This year, I think one book a month, that's 12 books a year. That is not that much. I feel like that is completely doable, so that's one of my goals. I really want to get my first tattoo. Again, another thing with acting, I want to be a part of a short film or like a commercial, something like fun and to just get me back into the swing of things. And also, I've never really acted on camera before, so it would be really cool to get to experience that and like just understand how the difference versus like theater. I would like to just be more content with where I am in life and not be just worrying about the next thing, what's the next step. I am very excited to get married and marry Dakota, and I'm excited for, you know, when we finally start having kids. But this year I really just want to focus on being in the moment and being present and being thankful for each and every day that I'm given, and take it a day at a time and not look so much forward. I think it's important to look forward to your future and to plan ahead, but at the same time I don't want to be so worried about it that I'm stressing myself out, because that's what I did this year. I just stressed myself out. So if you don't know this, I'm not super close to my dad. I didn't grow up with him very much in my life because him and my mom are not together. He just got out of prison, and I would like to get closer to him, and I would like to get closer to that side of my family because I just haven't ever been really close to them. And so I would really like to, especially like this year and just into my adulthood, I would like to get closer to that side of the family. And with that, I want to improve my Spanish, because a lot of my dad's side is Mexican, and so a lot of them speak Spanish, and I don't know hardly any Spanish, and I would like to, so I can be able to communicate better with them. My last goal for this year is I want to get back into drawing. I did during quarantine a little bit, and I used to draw in high school and middle school, and it just made me relax. I was able to put my headphones in, hyper focus on a drawing, and it just made me not think about all the things that stressed me out and things that are out of my control. I think that drawing is very therapeutic, and art in general is very therapeutic. So I would like to get back into drawing and just make my skill better at drawing. Thank you if you watched this video all the way through. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope, you know, some of these gave you ideas for what you want to focus on in 2021. This year has been horrible for all of us, and hopefully we can motivate each other to look forward to this next year and hope that it'll be better. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, subscribe if you're new, and yeah, I will be keeping you guys updated on my life, and thanks for watching. Bye guys.